SNES Drunk.
Hey everyone, and welcome to SNES Drunk Plays Super Tennis. As you can see, I decided to demonstrate this game by advancing all the way to the final of the first tournament of the game. It is on a clay court, it's the Rio Open, and I am John, the mighty John, against Kelly. Kelly's a guy, by the way. No offense to any dudes named Kelly, but here we go, three sets. This is just kind of not a tutorial, so to speak, but just kind of a demonstration of this game, like how to play it. And the reason, the step one to being decent at this game is picking the right player. And if you're new at this game, I would pick John 10 times out of 10. And the reason is because he is a power player. You know, the game incorporates all these different shots. Messed up the timing there. The game incorporates all these different kind of shots with topspin, backspin, overhand. But all you need to do with John is press the B button. Stay on the baseline. The baseline would be the bottom line there. And don't ever rush the net or anything like that. And you can just blow the ball right by him, just like I did just there. I'll get more into the detail of how to do that as we go. Here we get this chintzy change court thing. But yeah, returning in this game is tough. Really, what you need to do, step one, is get to the ball. That should be priority one when you're playing this game. Get to where the ball is. Position yourself to where the ball is headed. And step two would be to press the whatever shot you're going to play. Press the B button. In John's case, you want to hit the B button every time because that's your power shot. And step three is to hold the hell out of a direction, whether it be left or right. And it's really kind of a feel thing like that. Like, that's hard to do at first, but once you get there, you press the B button, like, you want to control the direction of where the ball is going to go as you're swinging, so to speak. So it really is like split second. Oh, missed that one. It is like split second differential, and that's why this game is based on feel so much. So it really takes a lot to get used to, but that's why I recommend starting with John, more of a power player. He'll run to the computer will run to the net most of the time, and you can just blow it right by him. Right. Now for serving, all you do is you wait for the ball to come down till it's almost right back in your hand, and while you toss the ball into the air, press the directional pad towards the middle of the court twice. Damn, messed that one up. Like right here, it's easier for me to do it on this side for some reason. Oh, he got to that one. But if you hit the directional pad twice, you will it'll hit like right down the middle, right on the line. Again, it takes a lot of practice, takes some feeling out to do. I still mess up the timing a lot, as you can see. So this game is pretty tough. But yeah, it's there we go. Yeah, stay back, press the B button. All that good stuff. So let's see if I can. Nope, couldn't ace another one by him, but I did win the point. Got it by him on the sideline there. I don't even know if I'm getting this tennis terminology right, to be honest with you. I'm not exactly Mr. Tennis. Now, quickly for this point, I think I'll show off like some of the other kinds of shots you can hit. I just want to get ahead first. Like, if you press the A button... messed up. Messed that one up there. He hit it. Didn't hit it where I thought he was going to hit it. See, it, like, sounds kind of different. Oh. Wow, what an idiot. Why did he hit that? That was heading out. But yeah, if you hit the A button instead... hits kind of like a floaty shot that sends the player all the way back to the net. Yeah, and if you hit the Y button, that hits like a high shot that will attempt to hit over his head if he comes up to the net like that. Technically, that's what you're supposed to do, quote unquote, if the player comes to the net, is you hit it over his head. I never do that. I'd rather just power it right by him. Play. So we're up 4-0. Again, the same thing applies to serves. Like if you press A on a serve, I don't think there's a Y serve. But if you press A on a serve, it'll be like a loopy kind of like that. It's a safer serve if you miss your first one and you want to make sure you don't double fault. You don't hit two serves out in a row. It's a safer serve. It's a better chance it'll go in and be playable. But I would rather do the power game. That's my thing. Let's see if I can finish off this set without giving up a point here. Should steal the Game Grumps joke here, where they say something to each other as they cross, like, asshole. Alright, John. The hardest part of this game is returning, I think. Returning serves, especially against another power. There are similar power players like John that serve the hell out of the ball, and it's hard to keep up. Especially serving from the top. Oh. It's another aspect of this game that's a bit tricky, is that... just missed that one entirely. Is that you serve from both sides of the court. Oh, missed that one. You serve from the bottom and from the top, and you also return from the bottom and the top. And that really, there's different, like, it's much, much easier for me on the bottom for some reason to serve and return on the bottom. As you can see, I might lose this point here. And, yeah. But it does, like I said, this game is 100% feel to it. Like, there's that split second between when you press the B button and when you press the directional pad. If you just hit the B button and you don't press the directional pad, the ball just goes straight to the middle of your opponent's side. It'll default to the middle. So you always want to hit a direction like that. All right, this is to win the set right here. Oh, and another thing I forgot to mention. I'll point it out next time. There we go. Well, I'll point it out next time. I'm defending a serve. Serving from the top here. Two sets. All I gotta do is win this set, and I win the match. That's just luck. Hit the top of the net and bounce in just barely. Ah. There we go. All right. Yeah, it's a bit tricky serving from the top too. It just has a different feel to it than the bottom for whatever reason. I can't really it's one of those things that's hard to explain. It's just when you play the game, you know what I'm talking about. It just has a different feel to it. That's one of the appeals of this game, I think, is that that way the match is never really boring. It stays consistently entertaining. Son of a bitch. So when returning a serve, the first thing I do is just tap the D-pad downward to give myself... serving it right past me. Press the D-pad and give yourself a little... That'll give yourself an extra split second. It's terrible. Should probably concentrate. Yeah, tap the D-pad before he serves. There we go. Wow, that was embarrassing. I just got... We're tied at one. This might take longer than I thought. Sorry, folks. Yeah, serving from the bottom for me, for whatever reason, is easier. It just... Like I said, you just lift the ball... Right when the ball... As the ball's in the air, you tap the directional pad. In that case, it's to the right twice. Just 1-2. And then you... Damn. And then you, right here, 1-2, bam. Didn't quite get it that time, but... 1-2, bam. There we go. And you wait for the ball to almost come right back down into your hand. So, it's pretty tough. It takes a lot to get used to. I mean, I've played a million matches. I've beaten this game, so... And that's 10 billion matches. Another thing worth mentioning is that clay... We're playing on this brown surface here, and that's clay. Aw, man. And that is... a little bit slower of a surface, so the ball takes kind of a higher bounce. You know, it's clay, as opposed to grass and hard court. Grass is much, much faster. It doesn't bounce. The ball doesn't bounce off the grass nearly as high. So it's much more predicated on speed, on movement. Clay is power, basically. Like, you have to, when the ball bounces up to you, you have to smack the shit out of it to draw it past him, past your opponent. See, that time, I didn't get the directional pad in time. I messed up my timing there. And so as a result, the ball went straight back to the opponent, like right in the middle. Out. So if that happens, you'll never get it past him. It's all about getting that feel correctly. Right. Have I mentioned that enough times? Feel? I think I should say the word feel 27 more times. There we go. 1-2. Let's go the other side this time. It does help to go to switch up the sides on your serve every once in a while. See, that time the ball just bounced right to me, so that gave me plenty of time to set up, press the B button, and then lean on the left directional pad to hit it way to the left as I'm swinging. And it's all timing. Not only is it timing with pressing the B button to hit the ball, but it's timing with the directional pad too. So it's like a twofold 1-2 split second, like literally split second timing. And it takes a lot of practice, but that's how you do it.
Play.
I'm hoping to finish off Kelly here. Yeah, this is the Rio Open. This is the first tournament in the game. Get there. There we go. Get there. There we go. The first tournament in the game, and I think after this you go to like Australia on your world tour or whatever. And you, that's when you play like what the game's equivalent of the Australian Open is. I think in this game it's called the Melbourne Open. All right, just one more point, serving for the match here. And that's considered a major. What? I didn't get to that in time. That's considered a major tournament. So right after this, you're thrown into the fire. This is your first tournament, and then you're thrown into a hard court. Major final. Wow, I'm not getting any breaks here. I'm down. There we go. I think this game has a total of about like 12 tournaments, I want to say. Something along those lines. Oh, didn't get there. Man, I'm going to lose this point. There we go. And of course, as I mentioned in my review, I'll link it here. Oh, I lost. I lost that point. Wow. Now it's only 5-2. I'm still 1 point away from winning. As I mentioned in the review I did of this game, the hairstyles and the clothing and pretty much everything about this game is very, very early 90s. Not only is it early 90s, but it's early 90s tennis, which had its own ridiculousness. Just Google image search Andre Agassi and you'll see what I mean. He wore some of the most ridiculous clothes. And then he wrote in his book that I think after like 92 or something like that, he eventually wore a wig that was kept on with like several dozen hairpins. Yeah, tennis was a whacked out from a visual standpoint, I guess you could say, back then. I guess it still kind of is. Ugh. Am I going to lose this point too? Jesus, I'm sorry.
Fault.
Come on. Got to concentrate now. But yeah, like I said, on serves, back up a little bit. Gives yourself an extra split second to set and to hit the B button, hit that return. Returning's the hardest part of this game. It's the hardest part to get down correctly to get the timing right. But once you do, I mean, that's like three in a row now. You kind of get in a zone. All right, this is for the championship, for the Rio Open. And got it. Rats! Now we get a chintzy victory screen. I am the champion of this particular tournament. Okay, so there you go. If you have any questions, just leave one in the comments. I really like this game. I think it's the best. I know I get a lot of... Everybody was talking about Smash Tennis. Was up there, too, as one of the best for Super Nintendo, for Super Famicom, rather. That's good, too, but I prefer Super Tennis. I just like the timing involved and all that sort of stuff. I don't know. Yeah, so there you go. I win, and now I am number one in the rankings. You can see the scores of my other matches there. So, that's pretty much it. Yeah, the whole goal of the game is to finish your season number one in the rankings. So, again, if you have any questions, leave one in the comments. I want to thank you for watching, and have a great rest of your day. Oh, God, not the horrific passwords. No, no.